It's time for intergenerational dialogue and co-leadership. It's time for young governments. It's time for young women empowerment. We must work together and co-create with youth, especially young women.
60% of the current population is young people, under 25.
And it will double.
Yeah. So that's why the conversation with us and with the new generations, it has
to continue. We have the average age of African leadership at 66, and we have the average age of the population at 25. So we have at least 40 years of gap between generations in leadership, because young people are the majority, but they cannot sit on a table and have a confidence to have a conversation or to feel they're listened to or to feel their voices heard or they're taken seriously. And so, you know, elders and, you know, other people in generations where they take youth seriously are important in this conversation, because they can, you know, enlarge the table and bring a young voice here, a young voice there, and make that conversation inclusive and make it empowering for the youth.
We need parliamentarians to come in and to hold governments accountable, that they have to allocate budgets for programs fighting FGM or child marriage.
Well, the gender agenda is my agenda, and it is young women agenda as well, as part of this also generational, you know, struggle, because we are a continuation of what have our mothers achieved.
This is not an issue to do with the older generation or the grandmothers or the mother's generation. This practice is continuing with the current generation. And we noticed from the different surveys that even the young generation, the young mothers, are still confused about this practice. Mm-hmm. And some of them are still defending it as a practice that is requested by the society. So that's why the conversation and the dialogue between the different generation has to continue. It has to continue. Us, our generation, we have the responsibility to take all the knowledge we have about these issues to our youngest generation, because them, they will take the lead with their generation, with their peers, and with the coming generations. And they can deliver the message better than us. That's my belief, that they can deliver the message better. They can't change their narrative.
Absolutely, so they can drive it themselves. So intergenerational dialogue, especially in Africa, is very important because of the generation gap, and we need to close that gap, and we need to talk about intergenerational co-leadership. It's not about us or the other generation, which one of us will lead, which one of us will take space. Mm-hmm. It's about us coming together to co-lead, because we need to take our continent to where she deserves to be.
One, two, three. One.